All right, everyone, hello once again, and today we are finally gonna finish Life is Strange Before a Storm with its bonus episode, Farewell, which is set before Max left for Seattle. So without further ado, let's dive right in. Oh. What the fuck?
Ready? I guess. But isn't your mom gonna freak? She's probably cooking with the radio on. She won't hear a thing. I bet she'll notice a hole in the floor. Just in science, Max. Even when science means blowing shit up.
Oh. Thank God. Fuck. Never mind, it worked.
Was truly amazing. Why are explosions so awesome? That's like asking why are puppies cute? Some things just are. I'm not sure your mom would see it that way. When she asked me to get rid of my old junk, she never specified how. But I guess I better do some actual cleaning too. I'll be excavating the closet. If you see anything else to trash, help a girl out and chuck it on the pile over there.
No. Why would I want to do that?
It feels like I've spent half my life hanging out in this room. Probably because I have. I can't believe those days are all over now.
Oof. I know when you'll see her again.
How do you tell your best friend that you're leaving her?
You'll see her again, fresh off of her girlfriend Rachel Amber getting doped up by a psychotic teacher and / or pedophile.
These boy band trading cards. Super cringeworthy.
Yeah, and hilarious. Remember when we gave them all makeovers?
You mean when you drew boobs on all of them? I was so mad at you.
But our friendship lived on. So too will these cards.
Oh, great. So she's going to be one of those people that doesn't want to trash anything. Good to know.
Chloe's mom wanted us to go through this pile of old clothes and find stuff to donate. Instead, we played dress up for an hour.
Well, that's not doing any favors.
Die young.
out with a bang. Rest in pieces, doll.
Really? Generic sorry?
What are you doing?
Adding this to the pile.
No freaking way. Just because I beat your ass every time we play doesn't make it trash.
Chloe, we haven't played this game in years. And it's missing half the pieces.
Nice try, Max. But you can't erase your shame that easily.
Ouch. Damn.
This was our first unsupervised concert together. It was so much fun. We were supposed to see another show next month, but
how sick was that show?
The sickest.
I've been working on my moves for the next one. Check it out.
What the fuck? Oh my god.
How about you? Any new moves?
Yeah, totally.
My god.
Damn, Caulfield. Save something for when it counts. Alright, back to the job.
Yeah, it hurts to see this. Let me guess, can't treat trash it.
Serious biohazard.
You promised me we'd finish it together no matter how long it took. Don't be
afraid. Oh. My.
You're right.
Yes! The never-ending candy lives on.
Okay, whenever I'm ready, I can go tell Chloe I'm done arguing about trash with her.
You better not be thinking what I think you are.
Chloe, I haven't seen you touch this guy in years. Why do you care?
Why do I care if you throw my beloved childhood friend into the trash? I don't think that deserves an answer.
Sorry, chum.
That's better.
God damn. This bitch just does not want to let anything go.
Hey, what's your dad's camera doing in here?
Dad said I could bring it up here for you to use. He's tired of watching you drool all over yourself every time he uses it. His words.
Your dad is the best.
Sure. Just don't ever tell him that. We need to keep him on his toes. You're off to a great start.
Actually, it's kind of cool.
Oh, great. Her and her selfie bullshit. Don't even try it. It's not worth it. No, just tell her. No, just say no.
That's it. I'm calling off the search. If you want more trash, you'll have to find it yourself.
Well, it wasn't exactly the purge Mom was hoping for, but at least we tried, right?
Right.
And now we've got the whole day ahead of us. What do two undersupervised friends with clean rooms and clean slates want to get into today?
I guess now would be a good time to tell Chloe I'm leaving. Or I could let us enjoy the day first and tell her later.
This.
Actually, Chloe, I really have to tell you something. I don't know how to...
Shit! Max, hold that thought. This must have fallen out when I was digging around in here. Do you have any idea what this is?
Whatever it is, It looks like it came out of our pirate phase.
Your powers of deduction are as strong as ever. This tape is from 5 years ago. It's a message from our past selves to our current selves.
So we were 8 years old? That's crazy. I can't even imagine what we sounded like.
Ready to find out?
Avast, future wayfarer! We have uncovered the audio log of the most fearsome pirates in the bays of Arcadia! Captain Bluebeard and Longneck Silver!
You were such dwarves.
So, you're in search of buried treasure, are ye? Well, if it's treasure ye seek,
my eyes spot two fair piped witches.
What a... Dad, get away! We're in the middle of an important project!
Oh, project. Never mind then. I apologize.
I mean it!
All right. Supper's in five. Wash your hands, you grubby pirate kids.
So lame. As I was saying, if it's treasure you seek, you've come to the right place.
What the fuck?
Forewarned, the journey was treacherous and full of treachers.
Nice.
To find the treasure of Price Isle, you will need the map from the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard. Only the map can lead ye to the treasure ye seek. But be forewarned. Again, only those with pure hearts will be able to see what the amulet shows them.
The amulet.
Good luck. And, bye.
Oh.
Dude, that was
so dorky. What were we thinking?
I thought we were lovable. Okay, forget everything. Today, we go treasure hunting. I think I know what 8-year-old you meant by the manuscripts of Captain Bluebeard.
Our old sketchbook. This is where we kept all our pirate drawings.
Yep. Now let's see this map.
What the fuck? Oh, oof. Poco. No boys on this shit. What the fuck?
This looks like a page was ripped out. I wonder if it's the map. Hey, check this out. This page was ripped out. Do you think it's the map?
If it is, there's no way I would have thrown it out. Maybe it's mixed in with the rest of the drawings?
So much for telling Chloe now. All she cares about is finding this map. Chloe and I were doing a lot of drawing in Miss Shelley's class. I wonder. Don't move. This angle is perfect.
Why be shy? Get in here, dude. Subject and photographer. You really do it all, Max.
I try.
Oh, hello there.
Bingo.
Chloe's secret lair. Dark caverns where the amulet is. Well, this doesn't really tell us shit.
I'm remembering this now. Didn't we make some crazy puzzle? We need the telescope and amulet, which we hid inside a dark cavern, aka the attic.
Why did we do that to ourselves? Because we were 8 years old and the attic was the scariest place we could think of.
You think it's still there?
Should be. As long as the clean police haven't gotten to it first.
Okay, and once we have the amulet and the telescope, we use them to reveal the treasure. Somehow.
Here's what's happening. I'll head to the garage to dig up my old telescope. You go find that amulet. We'll meet out back at the pirate ship.
You mean the swings?
Yes, the pirate ship. Captain Bluebeard and Long Mac Silver right again, bitches!
What the fuck?
I'll find a way to tell Chloe later. If this has to be my last day here, might as well have one final pirate adventure. Okay, Chloe said she hid the amulet in the attic. The only way in is through the broom closet.
Cool.
There it is, the dark cavern.
Except you're too fucking short.
I need to find something to stand on. I'm sure I can find something around here to boost me up.
And you're still too short.
I gotta find something I can stack on top of it.
For fuck's sake. God damn you, Max, for being so fucking short.
Seems like Chloe's dad always has a project around the house.
About that. I don't want to go back in there yet. Oh, look at that.
Almost there. I just need a few more inches.
What? You mean you're gonna stack something on top of that? This is not gonna end well. Nicotine.
Chloe's mom is trying to quit smoking. The principal at Blackwell wants to meet with Chloe's parents. Did Chloe voicemail? I wonder if it's still there. Sometimes I really wish I had siblings. Chloe hasn't mentioned. Chloe is such a nature nerd. I bet she's gonna love it. Most strikes? How can that be so cool and so dorky at the same time?
Great. Now, what do you stack on top of up?
I slipped and broke this post a few years ago. But Chloe insisted on taking all the blame. Even after she got grounded, she never squealed. What a friend.
This could potentially be really bad. What the fuck?
Awesome.
Except you can't see shit.
Man, there is a ton of stuff up here. How will I ever There it is. Of course Chloe hid the amulet in the hardest place to...
Oh. Where do I go?
I think I can squeeze through now. Chloe refused to get another goldfish after she had to flush Calico Jack. It's a good thing I'm big and burly. Otherwise, moving this furniture would be kind of difficult.
You think you're big and burly? That's... inaccurate. Oh,
single country record. These must belong to Chloe's mom. One step closer.
Yeah, I'm fairly certain big and burly is not what I would use to describe Max.
Still some things in there. I guess Chloe's dad went through a hippie phase.
Why are you surprised?
That's so cool. I wonder how many different moments this thing has captured. Long Max Silver's eye patch. This will be perfect. This thing is empty.
Old time cola. Oh, look.
Finally. Got you. This thing is cool, I guess. I wish I could remember how it works.
What the fuck? I'm so pissed about what I'm looking at right now.
Chloe Price. My best friend. It's so weird being back in this attic after so long. I remember being terrified of this place. I think when you're a kid, you're only afraid of things that can hurt you. But when you get older, you become more afraid of hurting the people you care about. And...
Alright. I get it, and spiders.
Are you just watching me up there, Creeper?
You are one of a kind, Chloe Price.
What?
I'm lucky you're my best friend. That's all.
Damn right you are, you mushy weirdo. You find the amulet? Awesome. Now get your ass down here, we have treasure to find.
Oh my lord. Way.
Cavern was no match for you, eh? Long neck silver to the rescue.
Treasure's sure to be ours, Captain.
Bring the amulet over here so I can see.
Chloe is so excited. I better bring her the amulet before she makes me walk the plank. This was a fun experiment. I'm almost surprised we actually managed to grow something. Poor Bongo. Chloe took his death so hard. I guess Chloe's mom comes all the way back here to smoke. Chloe and I have done lots of homework at this table. It's so weird we're at different schools now. I still wish I could live in the world we drew. I've spent so much of my life here. Every little corner is familiar. Comforting.
Are you gonna throw it?
These games we're playing. Buried pirate treasure from our past selves. Is this all selfish of me? Why is this making me feel more guilty about leaving? How am I going?
What's up, dude?
Bro.
Don't you mean sis?
Actually, I meant me. Dork. Punk.
Punks are cool. You know what, Max Caulfield?
What, Chloe Price?
You're the frickin' best. That's all.
Damn right. About time you realized it.
Tell anyone and I'll deny it.
No.
Okay, enough of this shit. There's treasure to be unburying. Ah, my greatest work of art. I call it how I lost my magnifying glass privileges.
Great art is never appreciated.
Yo-ho, yo-ho, a pirate's rum for me.
Do you drink this?
Yar.
What the fuck?
No, not really. fish an empty bottle from the recycling bin.
That's probably for the best.
Some pirate you are.
Hey, Chloe.
Yar.
Walk the plank. Perfect.
Wait just a minute.
Yar! You must ask permission before setting foot, peg, on another captain's boat.
Permission to come aboard, Captain Bluebeard?
Granted.
What the fuck?
Okay, I think it goes... Damn it. I forget how to make this stay on.
Stay here. I'll find something to hold it on.
Thanks, Max.
Time to stick the amulet to the telescope. Then Chloe's bottle rocket. The fastest way to get an entire bottle of soda in your hair. I wish this was big enough to jump in.
It's only September. It'll be totally dive bombable in a few weeks.
Yeah. A few weeks.
Too bad you won't be here.
All I'm saying is, I've never broken my wrist taking a picture. I'm really gonna miss Price Family Barbecues.
I'm gonna assume the tape is what we need.
Getting that treasure, whatever it is.
Oh, goody. Hello there.
If you told me this morning that we'd be spending the day as pirates, I would have thought you were crazy.
Yeah, I probably look like a loser, huh?
Yeah, totally. But we're losers together. See?
If you're a loser, Max, I don't think I want to be cool.
Oof.
It's just, this whole day has made me feel like a little kid again.
I can't believe we were 8 and 9 when we planned this.
I can. This tiny kid's head is squeezing the shit out of my head.
Well, treasures don't find themselves.
Lead the way.
Here.
Ahoy, Bluebeard. I have brought the stickiest tape in all the seven seas.
Well done, fellow scallywag.
Just like old times. Come on.
Remember how we used to talk about ruling the bays of Arcadia one day? We thought we were going to be pirates forever. If being a pirate means acting silly and going on crazy adventures together, then we'll always be pirates.
Hell yeah. To do the honors, Long Max Silver?
Me? Are you sure?
Of course. Come on, Navigator. Point me to some shore.
Oh, goody.
Wait. How am I supposed to use this?
The drawing on the lens. It should line up with something.
Here goes nothing. Okay. This drawing is supposed to line up with something.
Okay, well, how? Oh,
I'm so close. I just need to keep looking.
I'm so confused. What the shit?
I think I have the right angle, but where does it line up?
What the fuck? I'm gonna be honest, I don't know what the fuck.
Got it.
That's pure luck.
Where is it? Here?
Okay, take a step right.
Oh, shit.
No, the other right.
My other right or your other right?
My other right.
Got it. Wait, what?
Just go that way. Perfect. Now come towards me. Bingo.
Oh shit.
What the? That is not what we buried.
No, that's not probably what you buried. What the fuck?
Huh. Chloe's dad is such a goofball.
Ahoy there, plankwalkers! It's me, Bloody Bill, the Pirate King.
What the heck?
By now you'll have seen that I dug up your treasure, which would normally make us mortal enemies. But hear me out. I haven't pilfered a thing. On the contrary, I figured you swashbucklers might not be back to your loot for some time, so I've given it extra protection from the winds and rain. I'm sure you're excited to open your time capsule, so I won't go on too long. Just know that Bloody Bill is bloody proud of you. Both of you. Keep those sails trimmed and that anchor scrubbed. And always remember, the real treasure is...
friendship.
Love.
Your Oregon State prepaid college savings plan.
What?
That's what we originally buried.
Huh, yeah. I guess it probably would have gotten ruined underground.
Holy crap! It's Billy the Squid! He's alive! Oh, man!
It really is like a time capsule.
No way!
Chloe, look at this. We wrote each other letters.
Oh, I remember these. Chloe Price. Thanks, Max. I hope you are having a lot of fun being a teenager with your best friend. Aw, you're so cute. Check it out.
Ugh, seen.
Ooh. It is Friday. These are the things we like. Favorite animal. Max, like, oh, what the favorite food? Lobster roll.
How about mine? What did I write?
This is so Chloe.
Help. The record of how we spend our days. Can you guess which one is real? We go to the same school and always sit together at lunch. We have sleepovers once a week. We're extremely to see who can convince your parents to get a pet first.
Your mom going to mind about this mess?
Just dunno. I thought they'd be home by now.
Max, remember scratch art? Oh, I love this stuff. I'm gonna draw something.
All these memories. I want to look at everything. Now you've got something pretty to look at.
This is like really bittersweet because I know what's
Made
coming next.
One thing where Chloe outnerds me.
Oh.
I wonder if that's the voicemail Chloe's mom was talking about. She did say she didn't want Chloe to hear it, but if Chloe's in trouble at Blackwell. This might be my only chance to get her to talk about it.
I'm listening, fuck you.
This is Anne Rogers, Marissa's mother. Marissa from Blackwell. I need to talk to you about what your daughter did to Marissa in class today. I'll be keeping Marissa home with me tomorrow. At this point, I'm not comfortable sending her back to school at all. I don't know if your daughter is having trouble adjusting or what, but this needs to be addressed.
Hey, hold on. Are you serious? I don't want my parents to hear that. I've never gotten in trouble at school.
They already know. I saw an email on your parents' computer.
Shit.
What happened?
Something so minor. Her mom is exaggerating. I bet Marissa told her that I'm telling you, it's stupid.
Come on, you've got to tell me what happened. I'm your best friend.
And you read my feelings too well. I almost told you upstairs.
Man, none of this would have happened if I had you around. I wouldn't care what anyone said.
Sorry. I don't mean it's your fault. Anyway, she wouldn't leave me alone, so I turned up her Bunsen burner inside. Just a little.
What?
No one got hurt, not even close. You know that I know what I'm doing.
Chloe, what do you mean she wouldn't leave you alone?
She was making fun of my clothes and calling me a scholarship kid.
That really sucks. I'm sorry.
Yeah. Thanks, Max.
She got in trouble because she turned her Bunsen burner up, but nobody got hurt. What the fuck? Man, fuck Blackwell. That's some stupid ass shit if I've ever seen it.
Chloe and I have been friends for so long. Maybe I...
What the fuck? That wine stain.
Chloe and I spilled that wine months ago. But I still feel bad about it.
No peeking at...
Today's been awesome, huh?
For real. I love it when you stay over.
Yeah. You're such a space hog. Move over.
Nope.
Weird. Are you done yet? Okay, that's enough of this.
A time capsule was such a good idea. It's good to see you, old friend. Recording things was so much fun in third grade. It actually might be really fun writing once a week too often. Well, I run out of things to say. Most of these are pretty far off base. It's so hard to predict the future. Maybe it's better to enjoy the present instead.
Both of us are dating our second boyfriend. Well, that sure as fuck ain't happening, considering Chloe's a lesbian and you... Well, we all know what happened there. We do not make decisions without consulting each other. Both of us have a pet. What the fuck? One of us has a little sister or brother. Well, that's not true either.
These are awesome. Chloe's always been good at making up cool things to do.
Are you done yet?
Yes, I should try talking to Chloe again about my news.
Hey, hippie.
How's the masterpiece?
Working on the last bit. How about you? Done with the time capsule?
Yeah, I think so.
Well, perfect, because now I'm finished. Check it out.
This is so silly.
Jawbreaker.
This jawbreaker is going to last forever?
Just like our friendship.
Ooh. Chloe, you were really drawing me that whole time.
Whoa. Machinist alert. Keep it together, Max.
I guess now's my chance to tell Chloe I'm leaving. We might not be alone again once our parents get back.
Hey, ready for something else? I've got a great plan for the afternoon.
Crap. I don't want to ruin the rest of the day.
You're staying for dinner, right?
Would Chloe even want me to tell her? She's already got enough drama from Blackwell.
Max?
It's just Seattle. I'm probably overstressing about the whole thing. Right?
No, you're not, because you never end up talking to her consistently ever again. You're gonna tell her.
Chloe?
Max?
I want to tell you something.
Okay.
I'm family's moving to Seattle. Really soon. Hey.
In 3 days, right?
What? You knew that?
Our parents do talk, you know?
But they said I should be the one to tell you.
They still told my parents. I guess Mom and Dad were trying to keep quiet too, but they're bad at hiding anything. Don't look so worried, Max. It's okay. Come on, Dorfmeister. It's not the end of the world.
I should have just told you earlier. I feel so stupid.
Max, I said it was okay.
I was trying to tell you this morning,
but I totally distracted you with the pirate tape. Success.
Seriously?
I didn't want this hanging over us all day. Plus, I know you hate this kind of conversation, so I just left it alone, you know? Come on. I want to spend every minute we have together, having fun.
We'll keep in touch, okay? And visit, and maybe we'll move back. Who knows?
Chill out. We can go to college together. It's gonna be fine. We're Max and Chloe, remember? We're always together, even when we're not.
That's true.
Cool. Let's find something fun to do.
Oh. That, yep. I knew that was coming.
Stole the summer's thrill, and the river's cracked and cold. See, the sky is no man's land, a dark and plumed estate. Hope it needs a humble hand, not a fox found in your place.
Ooh.
voice, it could be a little bit like I was there. I don't know. Maybe this was a dumb idea. I would give anything to be there with you now. It's so hard trying to say what I'm thinking. If I could just see you. But we'll get good at it. Great at it. We'll write and talk all the time. And then you'll come visit and it'll be like I never left. I mean it. You don't have to worry about anything changing. You're dealing with so much other stuff. You don't deserve any of this. Chloe, listen. Even if we're moving for good, we are always together, okay? Even when we're apart, we're still Max and Chloe. I will always, always love you. Goodbye.
That was a shit way to end this game. Alright, well. That's gonna do it for this episode. Thank you so much for tuning in. If you like my work, feel free to like, share, and subscribe. And until next time, peace.